Hello, welcome back.
It's the last time I do any role-playing.
Duke! Finally, you're awake! You missed a lot. The President's claiming you attacked the aliens first. General Graves knows that's bullshit, but his hands are tied. He can't officially send you into Hoover Dam. But funny enough, we just happen to be going that way. Hang on, this is gonna be rough.
This gun effect is so shit. YouTube videos have better fire effects. Look at it. It's like two JPEGs that just switch between each other. Anyway, so I'll skip the shitty nightclub, strip club scene. For two reasons. One, it's the worst chapter in the game.
I'm gonna feel that one in the morning.
And two, it's a dream. I did get all of the rewards for the ego rewards,
well,
except
yeah.
For
you can see my dick from here.
Yeah, cool. I've never worked out what he means. I don't know if he's referring to that, but then I'd be concerned that his dick is L-shaped. Of course, he could be referring to something in the JPEG. I mean, that's obviously a real model, but anyway, so I never know what he's talking about when it comes to that. So I got all the ego rewards except for the ones for getting a million score on pinball, because I'd be there all day and I don't really feel like doing it, to be honest. Another railgun. It's a load of shit. So you got these shitty. Fuck that one. That's a load of shit. These throwing discs. There's a basketball there. That's where I just came from, though. So if I have to crouch. And up we go. Yes, I believe it's just up here. So I'm going to switch out one of my guns. Probably the RPG, to be honest. Oh, fuck this section. On console, because I play this both on console and PC, obviously. And obviously console comes with auto aim, so you can just snap two targets like pretty much instantly. Obviously with this you can't, but there you go. So you've got to take out the banshees that attack you. They've got quite a range on them. These guys can just blast away.
Oh. Suck it down.
Hopefully it'll cool down before. Yeah, there we go. Before it gets in range. Yeah, I believe I've gotten every ego reward so far except for the pinball machine. I haven't checked, obviously. We've got the chapter select to find out. But I'm not that fussed about it. And the ego rewards are only really a requirement for the hardest difficulty anyway. Fuck, I'm not gonna survive. To regen. This is what I mean when the regen system is way off, or the health system is way off, because it... It says you've got no health, but you're still taking a shit ton of damage. This is just a DPS race. Jump over this, got a checkpoint, jump over this. Let's go down here. Here we go. Yeah, it is a Devastator. So I'm going to change that for the RPG.
Double your pleasure.
Even if there's no block on the channel. Fuck. Maybe I should let us shoot straight first. Fuck. Time to hide like a little bitch. I wonder who playtested this game. Honestly, who thought it was a good idea? Take away the health and armor from Duke Nukem and then... That's one thing I absolutely hate. Regenerating health is a load of bull. Shit. I've always preferred health counters. And some health counters are shit, like the one in Grand Theft Auto 5 and 4. Where it's just a bar, that's no good either. That's just a load of wank.
I would
much rather have numbers, because at least then you can tell accurately how much health you actually do have. But I think I'm probably one of the few people that actually care about that shit, so... Right, it's back to us down. Just probably hide for a little bit. Like a bitch. Like a true hero does. Truly the bravest hero of them all, hiding behind pillars. Come on, this fuck is almost... Gotta be almost down by now. Oh, okay. I think he just time travelled. Alright, let's reload this shit. What's up here? Oh, okay, that's everything then.
Tonight, you dine in hell.
Oh shit, I was not expecting that. I don't know why he just stood there looking at me and not doing anything. Like a fountain. Anyway, there you go. Some stupid ass shit. Now this is my favourite chapter in the game. Actually, I think I said that about the hive. This is probably my second favourite chapter in the game. Mostly because, you know, you've shrunk, you get shrunk. And whatnot. Right then, first thing you want to do is backtrack. Ignoring the frame drops. And you want to head into the storeroom and you want to pick up the cigar. For some reason the door is closed behind you on this game. You have to breathe like this, and it's probably a good idea to stop smoking. Shit, didn't see that before. That didn't work. I was supposed to go through the door first, wasn't I? That was. If you're quick enough, you can... let me go this side. If you're quick enough, you can just hop straight onto the sink, so you don't have to worry about any of that bollocks. Got some pro tips for speedrunning Duke Nukem Forever. Up we climb this giant screw, or whatever it's supposed to be. And that was worthy of a loading screen. It's really sad that I've memorised all of the loading screens on this game, for fuck's sake. Anyway, we're going down. Hello! So there was a jump cut there. You may not have noticed it, thanks to my expert editing skills. But I had to record some separately, so I'm doing the narration, commentary, whatever you want to call it now. Yes. So I'm in the burger shop. Now, I've played this game a fair bit, and it's fairly obvious which ones have the pig cops under, the ones with the upside down cups. I just wanted to make sure I killed them all before I went down, because I knew I was going to get shrunk, and it's a lot easier to kill them now. Whilst you're normal size, otherwise it's a little, well, it's not really a challenge exactly, but you know, it's just so much easier and faster to do it that way. Anyway, so running along, the gas sack. I thought there might be some money in there. Up the screw thing, I'm not really quite sure what that's supposed to be. I've got the ammo. Almost messed up that jump. Walking along the tentacle thing, I don't know what it is exactly, but it's hot. Anyway, so yeah, I plan to keep pretty much the same four weapons the entire time. I want to keep the Devastator.
Take that, you dirty rat.
And the shrink ray, the shotgun, and something else. But anyway, I was just gonna hit by the door. Now obviously I know you're supposed to get them into the the shrink pads, but when you've got the devastator you can just blast them away. It's the first one you can, makes it easier. And until they shrink down, then you can kill them easily. So as you can see, there's Tunic and 3D machines everywhere. Yeah, so I've got checkpoints running along. Now, I believe this is the area in which you have to climb on all of the shit, and that's one of my favourite parts. Now, somehow I managed to completely miss that mousetrap. Completely didn't see it at all. And then it made me jump. Now I take these guys out. After a while I decide that maybe the pistol is better than the shotgun at that range. Even though a shotgun would actually, you know, work at that range. At least a normal one would. Granted, this one's a shrunk down version, isn't it? So it might be able to have half the distance, but... Anyway, yeah, so this is the, this is the area where the floor is electrified, I believe. Yes, it is. Yeah, so this is one of my favourite little sections in the game. Me having played this one, for some reason I couldn't shoot for shit here. Me playing this game so many times, I played it 2 or 3 times on the PlayStation 3. And then I played it, oh, I guess this is like the 4th time I've played it on PC now.
I wonder if his thoughts shrink too?
And some chuckle fuck. Brilliant. So I've played this game a lot, so I know enemy placements, load points, etc, all of that shit. But anyway, this is one of my favourite sections.
Welcome to the International House of Pain.
So yeah, I knew there was some enemies on the top shelf, but I wasn't entirely sure where they came from. But luckily the cans offer quite a bit of protection. You can see the cat slowly moving backwards.
If I promise to kill you last, I lie.
As they do when they're shot. So for a split second there's a bit of glass. For some reason I was having trouble jumping. I mean, my space bar is broken, but I don't believe that's the reason I couldn't get up there. It was just my own ineptitude. So here I tried to cheat. I don't know if it's called a cheat necessarily, but it's kind of just trying to skip a large portion of it. And obviously I try and jump on there and I instantly mess it up. And then obviously once loading is over, just about now, there we go. Oh, I try it again, but this time I go straight for the body. I have a look around to see if there's anything else I can jump on. And then I just go for the body. The Duke Waffles. And on this little hook thing.
If I was alone in here and clapped, would it be careful, Duke?
And there we go.
I think the
And then, of course, I just wait for her to finish gabbing, and then she'll come over and open the door for me. Somehow mustard sprayed on me from there. There we go. Through the vent, and to the next loading screen. Right, this is where you get the... This is kind of a boring section on this roof. You just fight off a load of enemies. That thing opens for you.
Fresh hardware.
Kind of feels like I'm watching this in fast. Like a faster...
I'd buy this for a dollar.
So anyway, yes. I trade my pistol, because at this point the pistol isn't really all that worth it, although I've been trying to take the pistol through the entire game. Up to this point. But I decided I need to, you know, get a better gun for now. Anyway, here come the enemies. Shoot them all. Now that's a good thing about the execute is you get full health. Once you do it. Right, well, I just had another recording issue. So I'm doing another narration screen point, which I don't really like doing. It doesn't really feel all that natural to me, to be honest. I kind of prefer doing it as I play. That way I'm, you know, got something to talk about as opposed to just gibbering. As opposed to gibbering. So I picked up the shrink ray, and I'm saving that for later. There's a specific couple of enemies that you fight here. Commandos, and I don't know what the flying thing is. But it's here, and... Oh, God. Oh. Yeah. So I'll wait for those guys to come down. I'll just have pickups for a while. This is where they send the commandos, no? Now they've got guns. And then it's the commandos. I don't think it's this one, I think it's the next one. Oh no, it's this one. Okay, never mind. So yeah, they would take quite a bit of damage, and they've got rocket launchers. But obviously with the shrink ray, it's just an insta-kill. So yeah, I could just shrink them down. Now obviously I take some damage on these guys. And after a while, the shrink ray does wear off, so I wanted to make sure I got him with a pipe bomb. Or a grenade, whatever you want to call it. I kind of just remember pipe bombs from the first Terminator. Kind of handmade explosives, homemade. Same difference. Mm. guess there's more. Obviously this guy wouldn't give me a break, so I had to deal with it. Yeah, as you can see, I got hit quite a bit there. And I just take him down. I'll get a checkpoint, and then I know that it's the big flying guy. Oh, for fuck's sake, it's done it again. Third time's a charm. So yeah, I noticed there's a big guy there, and then I instantly take him out with one shot. You're supposed to waste all my ammo. When you pound the hardest, you sort of, you know, learn all the tips and tricks and stuff that you can do. I mean, it's kind of just common sense, really, but, you know, when you pound the hardest, you do what you can. And then, I want to take the pistol through the entire game. Well, at least for as long as I can. I just grab it. Change it for the Ripper. So I've got a grenade launcher. Blasting people, pigs, enemies on the motorway, right outside Hoover Dam. This seems to be possibly the most famous dam built by President Herbert Hoover during the Depression. It's pretty much the only good thing he actually did as a president. If I remember my American history right, he was sort of he had a laissez-faire approach, which meant that the people got themselves into this, the people get themselves out, so that the government won't have to do anything, which is obviously a fucking terrible idea. Yeah. Anyway, so this Call of Duty-esque dropship, gunship, circling thing, kind of pointless. Other games do it better, obviously. Just boring shit. Everything to say either, just blast every enemy that comes out. I mean, they don't even really explode, they kind of just... Oh my god, again. Yeah, they just explode. Blasting them and stuff. I'm tempted to shoot a dropship, just to get away. I'm not paying attention to the Fahrenheit temperature of the gun. Circle back around. I just saw a little bit there. And then we fly back over here, and I believe the dropship comes back. So there's only two grenades away from it. So we drop down, I've got back half for something to do. Anyway, when he stops messing around, we get out. And they drop off our monster truck. I get in the monster truck. And then I leave it there for the next recording that I've yet to do. Although, probably by the time this goes up, I would have already done it.
So I'll see you next time.